Hey everyone, happy 2021. I have an announcement to make before I get into your chart, and that is what we're going to be doing different on this channel. I want to thank you all for all your wonderful comments, really warms my heart, but I would like to get online, upload to you on a weekly basis what we're going to do every Sunday. I'm going to be sharing with you a 36 card read, okay? I know a lot of you watch the tarot readings online. Super informative, and especially when we have 36 cards, which is something I've developed myself as an astrologer. I call it the Astro Tarot Spread. So you will have 12 different areas of your life covered every single Sunday. So hit that subscribe button, get the notification button bell too, so you'll see when they're uploaded. But that is my way of connecting with you a little bit more often instead of uploading these 12 videos once a month, okay? We get to be connected every single week, all right? So let's get into your reading now. Hello, Sagittarius. Happy New Year. Officially now, it's 2021. We're out of 2020, and I think that's something we're all celebrating here this New Year's Eve, right? Just feel, what is this new year going to bring all of us, right? I'm going to start out with you, which really pops out. And to me, that is that Mars now is going to be moving into your sixth house. January 7th to March 5th is going to give you a time to really focus on how you work, what you work with. We're not really talking career here. That's more the 10th house energy. The sixth house is how you work through your day-to-day, your routine. Now, you've had Mars stuck in your fifth house for months on end, right? Because we had that Mars retrograde, right? And so it was, I'm falling off my chair. So right now, I think this is going to be good for you because you have had more than anyone else in the zodiac, all this extended time to be creative, to think differently. Maybe you were having more time at home due to COVID, right? Allowing you to kind of work more on your hobbies or whatnot, but you have perfected certain things. And I want you to really pay attention to this, Sagittarius, because now you're gonna see you're not gonna really have all the same time that you have had, but what you can now do is take those things that you have perfected, worked on, all of these projects, creative projects, mind you. You can take that in and look at how you now can set up your day-to-day routine, okay? And be good about that. Mars is going to be here with you January 7th through that of March 5th. So if you can get down a daily routine where you can act most efficiently, this is good because that could be a routine that you can usher forward when Mars leaves this area and starts focusing on your relationship area of life. But then your routine is set so that you're not wasting time. You know, time is a commodity. I mean, it's important. We only have X amount of hours a day and we want to always use it to the max. So that is important. Then I see Venus also, January 10th through that of February 2nd. It has been cruising through your personal house in December, really giving you a lot of extra charisma, right? You might have been changing up certain things, maybe your wardrobe, maybe your hairstyle, whatever it is. Venus loves to beautify what it touches, and it was touching you in December. Now, as we move into January, from the 10th onwards, you're going to start looking at Venus collecting money for you because it's your income area and Venus rules money. So where is that money coming from? Maybe you're touching upon something that can give you an extra income stream, which is awesome. It's not going to be here long. You only have like 2 weeks, a little bit more, to kind of make it work for you because you want to think long term. It's going to be a year before Venus comes back. So whatever you place, you know, in your foundation in this area, that has the power to linger with you if you get it right. That's why I focus on this. What else is really important right now is both Jupiter and Saturn. They've been cruising along in Capricorn for the longest time there. And with Pluto, we've talked about that, which is now moving into Aquarius. For you, that is going to be your third house. And what that's going to do, I feel, now that you have been working this whole last year trying to figure out your income, how to make it, what's coming in, what's not coming in, and what's not coming in, how can I change that up? Some of you, many of you, maybe also have been looking at extra income streams. I think that is something that's going to behoove you. And but now, Jupiter and Saturn both is going to look at how you communicate, what you communicate and put out there. Now, if you get this right, if you focus on it, ask for higher guidance, and follow that intuition, you have things now that actually was a part of what was accumulated. Those extra talents and skills that you were developing in 2020 can now be put out into motion. And a lot of that has to do with what it is you're communicating or whatever it is you're sharing to get out there. Now, Jupiter wants to expand. You're going to feel that, how your wings really want to take you to those new heights, those new goals, and Saturn supporting it. And if this is something that truly feels good to you, that Saturn will lock it in. Even when these two planets separate and move apart from each other, whatever it's locking in now in this conjunction, it's infusing those two planets so that Jupiter will always have that security of Saturn when it starts zooming around your chart, and it won't get back here for 12 years, right? So don't just look at the transits here and now. That's what's happening right here and now. But the infusions, when they merge, it's where it's taking us through our other futures, right? And so this is how we grow, and this is how we become more of who we are, and this is how we really hone in on talents and skills that can really behoove us and help us in the future. So it's an important time, especially when they're traveling together in this area. So just as we turn the new year, Saturn is already 1 degree in Aquarius, 1 degree into that third house. Jupiter is 2 degrees. And remember, even though they hold their own energy as Jupiter and Saturn, the third house is ruled by Uranus. So Uranus, which rules Aquarius, is all about technology. So I just want to give you a little extra hint, little clue you can stick in there, that this is a time for you, Sagittarius, to develop what you can with apps and whatnot. You know, use the internet to the max, because who knows what you're going to be able to concoct. I love that. Love, love, love that. Then we have the new moon, and we always talk about the new moon and when and how to place our intentions. And for you here, 12th of January is what you want to focus on. This new moon is powerful. They always are, but it's powerful because it's going to be conjunct right there with Pluto. So it's intensity. It's going to bring your intensity up. It's going to bring whatever you're working on. It's going to bring intensity and focus into this new moon. That will be 23 degrees in Capricorn. So for you, it's all about money, how you make your money, what you can attract as far as money, right? So thinking about where you're moving now with that Jupiter, that Saturn, communication, and the internet, you know, anything that is technical advancement, and this new moon coming with Pluto, hey, there is potential side jobs for you, not just your day job that gives you that monthly income check, but you might just download a full new concept idea. Stick to it, hold on to it, even if you can't develop it all in that one day. Listen, you got a golden egg because it's your second house. You're the only one in the zodiac that's getting that, so mark my words, okay? Then on the full moon, January 28th, that is going to be 9 degrees in Leo, and that's in your sister sign. Works very well there for you, which will be your ninth house. Let me see, 12, 1, 10, ninth house. So what is that? The ninth house is foreign people and places. It's other countries. It is higher education. It's also teaching, so maybe some of you might see that either you're going to be wanting to teach, or maybe you're doing research as a student. Whatever it is, this full moon is going to be illuminating this area for you on the 28th. Then on the 29th, I just want to mention that. Why? Well, remember the new moon was going to conjunct with Pluto on the 12th. Well, Venus is going to come and meet that very same degree where that new moon Pluto was. And we know Pluto is intense. We know Venus rules romantic energies, you know, love and so forth, but it also rules money. So when Venus and Pluto meet up, that's intense, and it is a money-making aspect. And since this now will be in this area of your chart of the second house, again, this could be a good month for you to look at new income sources, maybe passive income streams, right? So we don't know where the future is going to go. Employment and all this and that. We don't know what Corona is going to do and maybe delay things getting back. And we know malls are and shopping strips, malls, they're closing down. I can't find my words. But so a lot of us have to think outside of the box. Where are we going to go from here? So for you, you know where it is that you want to check out. All right. So listen, I'll see you again here pretty soon. And remember to subscribe now, so that you can get my weekly 36 card reading, the Astro Tarot reading, where we're definitely going to be digging in on a weekly basis for you. All right, see you soon. Bye now.